Evo is what we're talking about. And we're talking about the perfect way to spritz what you're cooking or air frying or whatever you may be doing, or seasoning, with the Evo sprayer. And this is a set of, not one, but two. You're going to be able to choose a set of two in the yellow, set of two in the red, set of two in the blue, or a set of two in the green, and that green is a deep olivey green, or kind of a caper green. You should know also you get these little printed throat bands that are stretchy like a rubber band. So you'll be able to put these on the throat of the bottle if you want to label one, say, balsamic vinegar, then that changes out to sesame oil. If you can see that, I'm sorry, I'm not doing a very good job at that. There we go, sesame oil. So all this comes together, and there's a little funnel to make it easier to fill them. Richard Roman is here.
Dave,
welcome back,
to
sir.
See you.
Good to see you,
yeah.
Pal. You know, this has been a crazy busy show, and I think we're about to send our phone lines back into a frenzy. These are awesome.
Yeah, David, Evo has changed the way I use oil in the kitchen, and it is the first and only non-aerosol trigger sprayer that actually sprays oil, atomizes the oil, and that's because of our patented technology in this trigger.
And before you do that, I'm going to move the fan
over
here, just so the fan doesn't spray the oil.
Quite right, and each pull of this trigger is going to dispense 1/4 teaspoon. So the problem when we're using oil in the kitchen is we usually use too much, and we kind of drown our food. Well, here to show you what a 1/4 teaspoon is, I actually measured out a 1/4 teaspoon. So typically, when you go to pour the oil on your food, you don't get very far with a 1/4 teaspoon, right, David? You only get it in a small area. So what do you wind up doing? You take your bottle, right, and you pour it all over the food and use tablespoons and tablespoons of oil. Not only are you wasting it, but you're drowning the food. With this patented trigger, I'm going to take that same chili oil. I use chili oil so you can see it. Check this out, David. I spray it over an entire area. That same 1/4 teaspoon, instead of being in one small area, it's now spread on your food. Now, here's an important tip, David. To get that spray, you want to make sure you pull the trigger with a little bit of speed. That's what gives you that nice compression and disbursement. So now I get flavor with very little oil over all my food. It completely changes how you use the oil in the kitchen.
You know what? I'm going to put this out here for you
absolutely.
Also that if you own an air fryer and over a million you have purchased an air fryer on QVC, that's why I put an air frying chapter in my new cookbook, because so many of you own air fryers. If you own an air fryer, you owe it to yourself to pick up the Evo bottle. Now, look at the size of these mutant Brussels sprouts.
Yeah.
I don't understand them. They're very large.
So, David, here's the thing. Take your vegetables before you go to the grill. Instead of pouring them using your hand, I want to, again, use that chili oil. Check this out. 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's a teaspoon of oil I spread over an entire sheet pan. So I got a little bit of oil in every little bite.
You know what else would happen if you drench these with oil and then put them on the grill?
Flare-ups.
Flare-ups.
Exactly.
You'd have terrible flare-ups, because as soon as that oil hits that open flame, kaboom, right? So you do a spritz, you're going to have a much more manageable situation. You buy frozen french fries for your air fryer. How many spritz of oil do you use?
I'm going to use 3. So I'm using the chili oils. Again, just so you can see it. 1, 2, 3. That's 3/4 teaspoon. And like you say, give it a little shake just like that.
I say chili oil on the fries might be tasty.
That's awesome. But check it out. You could see how every french fry just got a little bit of oil. So you're using very little, so less calories, but better flavor. As a chef, David, this gives you better flavor without using the excess amount of oil.
Which is exactly right.
Yep.
And the reason you want 2 of these is because you could put balsamic in one.
That's right.
You could put oil in the other. You know what? One of our producers, Sean, that works with the show pretty regularly, one time told me, David, could you put soy sauce in one of those
spray
bottles?
You absolutely could.
And you know what? I, as you know, tend to order Chinese food every Sunday night.
Okay.
After I've cooked all day, I want to, you know, order delivery. And I love soy sauce, so I buy low sodium soy, so I'm not ingesting so much sodium.
That's good. That's...
But I tend to be too heavy handed, even
yep.
with the low sodium soy. So now you put this in the Evo, and you just give your dinner a quick spritz, and you get the flavor without drowning it in all that oil.
And Dave, it's so convenient. Here's again, if your pans, instead of using those aerosol sprays which have chemicals, and you know, let's face it, we don't want chemicals in our food, you pick the oils. Now, I'm gonna use balsamic, and this is one of those wonderful Le Creuset pieces that you just had amazing deal.
They were so popular.
Check it out. That's 1/4 teaspoon. I use balsamic so you can see it. So use very little oil. Now you can sear your meats, saute your vegetables, you name it, use it right in the pan.
If you want the green, we're now last call in the green. I have fewer than 200 sets left in the green, and this green is a deep olivey green. It's kind of a caper green, so that'll give you an idea of the color there. Here is your blue. Here's your set of 2 in the red. Oh, just got a whiff of that balsamic.
Okay.
And here is your yellow. Can I tell you that we have now taken orders for 1,500 sets are gone. A lot of folks are buying more than one set because these make great gifts as well. If you want to put together a little welcome gift to someone in the neighborhood, or stocking stuffers for a foodie on your list, or in these remaining waning days of summer, Maybe you're making caprese salad, but before you dress that.
Oh, green is gone?
Green is gone.
Thank you, William. I have to use this one to spray.
Thanks, buddy.
So, Dave, check this out, okay? I'm gonna go to a caprese salad. Now, here's a very important point.
For caprese.
The further you are away from the plate, the wider the fan, the harder you pull the trigger, the wider the fan. So if you wanna get some control, get close to the plate and pull little short bursts, just like that. So that's not even a teaspoon, but notice how I got a little bit of balsamic over each and every bite. I love doing this because you're literally directing the oil right onto your food. It's not on the plate, and look at how this is glistening right across. The flavor, David.
And let me tell you what's gonna happen here. If you go out and spend good money on heirloom tomatoes and fresh buffalo mozzarella and fresh basil, and you come home and drown it with these other things?
Yeah, what's the point?
Why did you spend all that money on really good ingredients? You aren't going to taste them. All you're going to taste is the balsamic and oil. Here you get a nice spritz, and you get the flavor, but it doesn't cover up the great flavor of those tomatoes and that mozz and also the fresh basil.
Again, steamed vegetables. If you're somebody that's trying to get flavor with not excessive calories, again, I can go onto a whole plate of steamed broccoli here, and now I take my trigger, get right in there, David. That's a teaspoon of oil. Each and every floret now has just a little bit. And what I love about it, if you say, I want to add a little more oil, you can add a little bit at a time with Evo. You're not pouring that heavy stream. It's just a delicate compression of the oil. This is what makes this different than any other sprayer out there. And this is the first and patented one to do it. I love it.
And maybe you're going to prepare that gorgeous salmon to go in the oven.
Yeah, absolutely. This is what I love. So you take, I'm going to use the balsamic so you can see again. Whole side of salmon. Check this out. One, two, three, four. That's a teaspoon right there. Now I can go in with my oil. Before I grill it, roast it, broil it, you name it, I've used a teaspoon of each, the vinegar and oil, and look how the entire fish is evenly coated. Limited amounts, but great flavor with great less calories.
So I will tell you, we've now taken orders for 3,800 sets of these. We've sold out of green. I have it left in set of two yellow. Set of two red, and the red is very popular. That's never a surprise. And then we have the set of two blue. These are going very quickly. Remember, every pull of the trigger is a quarter teaspoon of whatever you have inside. So I have a real quick question for you
before
we wrap up, because I noticed the corn there.
Yeah.
Can you put melted butter in this?
No, right now we don't in butter, because butter, it'll actually solidify the fats.
So it has to be solid.
Yeah, that'll clog it. Yeah.
But if you wanted to spritz that with, say, a chili oil or something.
Corn, come on, Dave, look at this.
With a little chili oil.
And look, again, it's a nice alternative to the butter, but look how it gets, I just love how it gets a little bit of oil in every little bite.